city commission, and I would like to certainly recognize, not, I'm going to recognize alphabetically, just to keep everything on the straight and narrow. Mike Farmer, I'd like you to raise your hand. Doug Fassett, Robert Johnson, Junior Noffel, David Prater, Jeff Vaughn, and Martha Popeout. And again, somewhat similar, well, certainly very similar, in being able to shuffle the order of the questions, as all of you are well aware, through letters ahead of the questioning. So we have four particular questions to pose to each one of you, and we would certainly hope you will respect the time frame in which you have to make the answer, and we'll keep this moving along very favorably for everybody. So with all of that in mind, for the first question, the order is, and I'll just call your first name, Mike, David, Jeff, Doug, Junior, Robert, and Martha. And the first question is, and there will be some similarity in these questions to what was previously asked the mayoral candidates. The first question is, and posing to you, Mike, first of all, if elected to office, what is the first thing you will do to make the appearance of Lake Street, Main Street, and Commercial Avenue more inviting to the citizens of the city, as well as to attracting new residences, new residents, and new businesses?
Okay, well, we have Public Works. We have two part-time employees that are cleaning the area on a daily basis now. Commercial Avenue needs more than just cleaning. It needs some renovations, a couple of buildings there. Lake Street, it's an ongoing project. I'm hoping that with Public Works, we can just continue cleaning it on a daily basis and go from there.
Okay, thank you.
Dave?
Thank you, Mike. I think that, you know, we're talking about the businesses on Lake Street, commercial drive. I own a business on Lake Street currently, and I think it's definitely, along with working with Public Works, you also need to go to those business owners and actually talk with them and say, you know, this is not just a city effort of Public Works cleaning up in front of your business. You know, we need to work together as a group of businesses, and you actually, take pride and respect in your business and make it look good. Thank you.
Thank you.
First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out, especially on this cold, dreary night. That's hard. We need a little rain. There's a couple of people in this room that have come together to form a citizen action group, and they know who I'm talking about. And we have discussed this beautifying the downtown area, the commercial street area, so on and so forth. And it just so happens I am on that beautification committee. We've discussed some things that other towns in this area have done. Take Martin, for example, just little things that they do just to make their downtown area look nice and more attractive and so on and so forth. But I believe that's where it needs to be. The business owners, they need to take pride in what they have, because Public Works can't do it by themselves. Yes, we have people down sweeping all day, all night, not all night, but the business owners have to take pride in it. For instance, we're in the fall season. We should fix up our downtown area in the fall thing. Spring, same thing. And that's just my opinion, and that's something that we're looking into. Thank you.
Thank you. And then we'll close with Junior. I'm sorry, then those on the Doug.
As Mike and everybody said, it's going to take a team effort. We've got one of the best public works that I think around. When I first moved here to Fulton in 79, I worked for Public Works for 3 years. And I know what these guys go through, and I know what's involved in cleaning. The flower boxes that were put out a couple years ago on Main Street, Commercial, to keep them up, to try and keep it all. But everybody's going to have to basically take pride in their work, take pride in their stores and the streets to help everybody. You can't expect an owner to do it. You can't expect Public Works to do it. It's going to take everybody to do it.
The downtown area has been improved over several years. Over the, a lot of the buildings have been redone, but still you got to keep them up. And if you look across from the buildings, you can see those trees that have been planted. The pear trees, they make a beautiful scene in the spring. And everybody tries to take care of property if they can. Thank you.
Like it was stated in text, also the Public Works and working along with the people in the community and the stores and everything, all of them need to come together in the unity to do this. Don't depend on one person to do it. Don't just depend on the Public Works to do it. And don't depend on the people in the stores to do it, but all of them need to come together. That's what we need, to come together in unity, because where there's unity, there's strength. We come together, and they need to clean up downtown and everything, and all the trash they throw out. I see a lot of trash thrown out on the street, and they just driving by. But they need to keep the community clean.
Thank you, Mark. And Mark?
Well, I agree with everyone here, but there are a lot of vacant lots in downtown Fulton, and I think something needs to be done with the vacant lots. Community services could go and do them, or you could ask women's group or another group to take one lot at a time, but it looks pretty vacant in certain spots. And I really think this needs to be done. We mentioned dilapidated buildings on Mercer Avenue. The creek always has to be maintained and clean. No trash in the creek. And there at the end of Lake Street, there by the Christian Church, the creek, all of the concrete's falling in. So there's a lot of attention needs to be paid to making Fulton attractive in order that we do attract industry. That's what we need to do to stay afloat.
For question number two, the order for response will be Doug, Martha, David, Robert, Mike, Junior, and Jeff. And question number two is, what are specific areas in which you propose to help cut costs from city expenses?
Well, a lot of the specific areas, it's hard to really call because everything just kind of factors together all in one thing. We could cut probably in the fire department, there could be cuts, police department, there could be certain cuts. As far as long as it's City Hall, there could be cuts in there. Specifically what it is, we don't know until we have to look at it. But I think all the areas and everywhere, there's no one specific cut that I would say. In all areas through all the departments, there just needs to be certain things need to be, and there is certain cuts that could be made to keep from raising taxes, raising rates and everything there. Thank you.
Thank you. And
well, since I don't know the budget, I can't tell you where the cuts are made. But I definitely work with a hard budget where I work.